Good morning, Friday, February 8th, 2008.
From NBC News, this is Today with Matt Lauer and Meredith Vieira. Live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
And good morning. Welcome to Today on a Friday morning. I'm Matt Lauer.
I'm Meredith Vieira.
It is now 7:07. Turn back to Matt. Meredith and Al this morning. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday to you. And that's right. And how's the weather looking over the weekend?
Well, we've got a big Arctic blast coming into the Plain States and working its way to the east. Let's take a look at the map.
Now on this Friday morning, February 8th, 2008, a TGIF crowd gathered outside in Rockefeller Plaza, and Al Roker anxiously looking forward to heading out there to talk with them.
And windy, 34 Monday.
98th birthday of the Boy Scouts. Thanks so much for coming down.
We want to make you our honorary Cub Master.
All right, there you go. We're always prepared.
We have a hat.
Oh, and a hat. There you go. All right, now let's go back inside to Matt.
Good look, Al. Thank you very much. For the first time in a while.
Okay, some of these tests should be annual, some periodically. Let's start with the ones that are periodically.
It's about prevention and early intervention. That's why we're doing it. Everybody should know what their blood pressure is, what their cholesterol is. That's critical, okay? Now, there are certain tests that need to be done periodically. Certainly, you need a mammogram as you get a little older. Mm-hmm. You need to have your eyes checked for glaucoma. Younger women need to have their HPV test. That's the human papillomavirus along with their pap smear. Okay, everybody should look at their skin, looking for melanoma. People need to look at each other, you know, and on a yearly basis.
Okay, so those are all annual, and it varies. And the men have different tests, right, that are important for them.
You know, younger men have problems with their testicles and testicular cancer. They have to have, you know, to be looked specifically there. But the blood pressure, the cholesterol, body weight, very important.
And you say that the key test may be around the middle of it.
Right. The single most important test, I think, is measuring your waist circumference. You could do waist to hip ratio, but waist circumference is the single best marker for what we call metabolic syndrome, your risk for diabetes and heart disease and hypertension. The simplest test known to man. Measure your waist size. If it's growing, you've got a problem.
All right, Dr. Lim, thanks very much. And now here's Matt.
All right, Meredith, thank you.
Okay. Also got washer fluid. It's one of those things where you always forget about it until you need it at the day. Do it on the weekends. Again, check these monthly on a first Sunday of every month.
And then oil right here?
Well, oil. You have dirty oil. This is what the dirty oil looks like. At about 3,000 to 5,000 miles, depending on what the manual for your car says. And this is what clean oil will look like right when it comes out.
That's a big difference. And finally, tires, right? Check your
tires are very important. Check them on a monthly basis and check it to the manufacturer's specs for the car, not for the tires.
And the lights?
Well, lights are something you need to do because you don't want to get a ticket for out brake light. So what you do is have a friend stand behind the car, put your foot on the brake, put it in reverse with your foot on the brake, and just let them know if they're working.
All right, John, thanks very much. Back to you, Matt.
All right, Meredith.
Finally, you're home. You might be surprised what needs a tune-up around the house. Andrew Dan Jumbo is host of DLC's Take Home Handyman. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Meredith.
I know, the first one obvious, the battery, the smoke alarm.
That's right. Test these monthly. If you find they don't work, replace the batteries on all the smoke detectors. It's obviously a very important thing from a fire hazard standpoint.
So. Okay. What are these? These are filters.
These are filters, yes, for your whole house furnace. You know, most furnaces have a fan that blows the air around. Make sure they're clean. You can hold them to the light. If you can see through them, they're fine.
And how often should you do that? Once a year?
I check them every 3 months. And
right.
It's amazing. If you don't do this, your furnace works a lot harder to keep the house warm or cool in the summertime.
And what's the difference between this one and this one?
Just various furnaces have different styles of filters, but they're very cheap, about $5, and it'll help you save a lot of money when it comes to running your heating system.
Now, this is found behind your dryer?
That's right. This, you know, there's a lint screen on the dryer. Most
right.
folks clean that out, but forget about this behind the dryer. This is the duct that takes the air away.
Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get